We are now joined by Winterhawks great Derrick Pouliot. And Derrick, thank you so much for joining us this intermission.
Yeah, thank you guys for having me.
Now, obviously, you have your break right now playing with the Vancouver Canucks. And the Canucks, much like the Columbus Blue Jackets, are one of those teams that harbors a couple of former Winterhawks. And your head coach right now, Travis Green. And I guess that's my first question. Let's start there. What is it like playing with, or I should say, being coached by Travis Green at the NHL level? Also, Sven Berchi as well.
He's still the same Travis that I remember from my days here in Portland. He's, you know, the same guy. Lots of the practices and stuff like that is the same, the systems. So it's good. It was really good once I got traded there to see a familiar couple faces. It made things a lot easier in transition.
Travis, obviously, the head coach of the Winterhawks the year 2012, 2013, went to the Memorial Cup. You know, I remember Travis riding you a little bit hard a couple times during that season. Does he still get on your case every now and then?
Yeah, a little bit. I mean, he knows what kind of player I am, and I know what kind of coach he is. So he can be a little hard on me, I think, at points, but, you know, it's not without reason for him. He knows what, you know, makes, you know, the buttons to push for me. So it's really good to have that in a coach and to have somebody that believes in you the way he does.
So obviously you traded for the Pittsburgh Penguins. You actually played under Mike Johnson in Pittsburgh just a little bit. Talk about the transition coming from Pittsburgh into Vancouver.
Yeah, I mean, it was great having Mike there in Pittsburgh. I thought he did a good job. The transition going from Mike, I mean, he had the coaches there now with Mike Sullivan had, you know, some of the similar systems Mike Johnson had here. And Travis obviously has some of the same systems that we had here in Portland. So transition has been very smooth for me. There hasn't been a coach necessarily that I've been unfamiliar with. So it's been good in that regard. And it's been really easy to fit in everywhere I've been.
Here at the Veterans Memorial Coliseum, obviously a lot of memories for you. So my question to you is, when you enter the building, and I don't know when the last time you were here, when was the last time you were here inside the VMC?
I guess it would have been, I don't know, when I was 20 years old, so I don't know, about 4 years ago now.
Well,
so.
Well, then that's a perfect question. When you enter this building for the first time in about 4 years, is there any one particular moment that comes to mind, or is it just too many to count?
Yeah, I'm not sure. I mean, we won a lot of games here. We had some big moments. I think one of the moments that I remember is just kind of sitting up in the stands. There's nobody in the rink. It was my last year here, at least that I figured, and it was my last year as it turned out to be. But I was just sitting up there. There was nobody here. I was like, yeah, this is it. Like, this has been 4 years. It's been four unbelievable seasons. A lot of great people, a lot of great players. And this is the last game, I'll ever play. That was the last game I'll ever play here. So I think that's the most vivid memory I ever have.
Well, obviously, that year, 2012, 2013, go to the Memorial Cup. Dominic Turgeon gets his debut this week for the Detroit Red Wings. That's the 10th player from that team that has at least played a game or two in the NHL. That is just an incredible statistic. When you have 23, 24 guys in the roster, nearly half of them have got in the NHL at some point. Do you still keep up with those guys? I know you and Brendan Leipzig had a moment on the ice up in Vancouver, a picture of you two kind of joking and laughing at each other. I know you guys were like brothers here. I almost killed you your rookie year because you sat behind me on the bus. But talk about that. Do you still keep up with the guys that played on that team?
Yeah, for sure. You keep up with all those guys. I mean, even if it's just, just a little bit. You always, see those guys whenever you visit their city or they visit yours. You talk to them. You make sure you make the effort to say hi. So, it's awesome for Turge. Awesome for everybody that's, made it to the next level since I've been here. And it really, it's a testament to this organization how professional and how well they develop players. So it's great to see all those guys, doing well for themselves.
So now that you've been in the NHL for a few years and now you're really your first year as a full-time NHL player, you played with some great talents. You played with Crosby, you played with Malkin, Letang, now in Vancouver with the Sedin brothers. Do you ever go on the ice still sometimes and there's some guy opposite you that you go, holy crap, I can't believe I'm playing against this guy?
Yeah, no, it's still, it's hard to believe sometimes. I mean, It doesn't matter what team you're playing. They always have one or two superstars. So it's like, I mean, these are the guys you grew up. You know, when I was here, I watched these guys, you know, in the room at home. Like, holy, these guys are unbelievable. And then you go, you step on the ice with them or against them, and it's pretty amazing. I mean, the Sedin twins are, they're unbelievable how they move the puck, you know, amongst themselves and to their teammates. You know, Sid, Gino, Chris. You know, it's really, it makes you kind of take a step back and be like, huh, you know, I've made it to these guys' level in a way. I mean, I guess, but it's phenomenal, and it's a dream come true for sure.
And you talked about how it shows how much this franchise gets it right with the amount of players that end up making it to the NHL. And you talk about your team in particular. What is it about Mike Johnston's system that seems to produce and makes an easy transition for a lot of these players, whether it's from the WHL into the AHL into the NHL? Does he just kind of create that professional atmosphere or the way he teaches the game?
Yeah, I think for sure he creates that professional atmosphere for sure. I mean, with the staff he has, with Rich and Peaches and the off-ice training and everything, you know, top to bottom, it's top class for sure. You know, with the style of game that he wants to play, the speed, transition, you know, high-tempo game, that's where the game's going right now. I mean, every team wants to play that quick game, you know, skating game, and that's how he wants his players to play. So, I mean, I remember from my days here, we did a lot of, you know, on-ice conditioning, and, you know, it paid off in the long run for sure.
You talk about that a little bit. You know, for Portland, a lot, you know, four consecutive years into the league final. So I think every year you played in the league, you played in the league final.
Yeah.
I mean, that is pretty much unheard of. But when you were drafted first overall in the Bantam selection, the Winterhawks weren't a great hockey team at that point. You know, can you recollect back on that draft day when your name was called number one overall to Portland, what your thoughts were, and did you even have an inkling of who Portland was or where it was, or, you know, kind of look back at your past and remember that day if you can?
Yeah, I mean, when I look back, you know, I remember sitting down with my parents and saying, hey, you've got, you know, two options. Like, you're going to either go to Moose Jaw or you're going to go to Portland. They just had an ownership change. Like, things are looking up for them. Like, this guy seems really good. He's bringing in a new coaching staff and everything. And, you know, when I was thinking about it, I was like, I want to be with, you know, a team that's going to compete, a team that's going to, you know, prepare me for hopefully a career of some sort. And, you know, I really didn't have much hesitation coming here. And Mike, you know, was a big part of that, and his staff there. So it was really great to come here, and I had a phenomenal 4 years here.
Well, obviously, Derrick, your numbers speak for yourself. I think 205 career points in the Western Hockey League. You know, power play guy, special teams, didn't matter. And as, you know, as a broadcaster, it was fun to watch you work the game because you skated so well. When you're watching this team now, I mean, you look back at these junior players playing, do you see some things that maybe remind you of you when you were that age?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I see the same things that we were doing when I was here. They all skate well. You know, they move the puck quick. They get it up the ice and get in the other team's end. You know, there's not a lot of dump in the puck. If they have the play, they try and make it. So it's you know, some of the same stuff that I was taught by Mike and Travis and those guys. You know, it's good to see. It's a great way to play the game.
We got time for about two more questions. I got one more. There's four first-round picks, NHL draft picks, on this roster right now. They're looking, you know, towards their future. They're looking at the AHL. They're looking at the NHL. Is there any advice you would maybe give towards them that perhaps you had when you initially left the Western Hockey League?
Yeah, I mean, one thing I would say is, you know, if it doesn't work out, you know, right off the bat, don't worry about it. Just keep working. You know, keep playing the way that got you drafted and got you noticed by these people. You know, it might not be the same organization now that I've been traded before. It might not be the same organization that likes you and gives you, you know, the opportunity to play, you know, at the big stage. So it's, you just gotta, you know, stick with it. Do the things that make you the player you are, the player that got you noticed, and just, you know, don't ever lose faith.
I don't have any last questions. I want to say thank you for your time, and you know, it's, I'm glad you're able to come back to Portland. A bye week, you know, it must be nice to have at least one of those during the regular season.
Yeah, no, it's great to be back here, and I'm having a good time.
Well, thanks so much, Derrick, and you know, like I said, I think I speak for a lot of fans here in Portland. Enjoyed watching you play here, and we wish you the best of luck the rest of the way with the Canucks.
All right, thank you.